Taran tan tan taran tan tan tan. Natural Science Class with Teacher Fernando. In this video, we are going to learn about the classification of living things into the five kingdoms. Living things are classified into five groups called kingdoms. The organisms in each kingdom share the same characteristics. Here in this picture, we can see the five kingdoms. So we have the animals in the animal kingdom, the plants, the fungi in the fungus kingdom, the bacteria in the Monera kingdom, and the protist in the protist kingdom. Now let's find out about them. The protist kingdom. Most organisms in this kingdom are unicellular and they live in water. We can find in this kingdom algae and protozoa. Algae use photosynthesis to produce their own food, and protozoa absorb food from the environment. The Monera kingdom. Organisms in this kingdom are unicellular. Bacteria are included in this kingdom, and most of the organisms in the Monera kingdom are bacteria. We can find these organisms in all types of ecosystems, even inside other living things. Like we can see here, bacteria inside our digestive system and the small intestine. The fungus kingdom. Organisms in this kingdom can be unicellular or multicellular. Fungi cannot produce their own food. That is why we call them decomposers. So they are decomposers. They feed on organic dead matter. The plant kingdom. Plants are multicellular organisms. They can make their own food with the photosynthesis. Also, they provide food or habitat for other living organisms. Food, it's easy to understand because many animals feed on living things from the plant kingdom, such as plants, vegetables for humans, okay? And they provide habitat for other living things, such as insects in the flowers or birds that have their nests in the trees. And last, the animal kingdom. Animals are multicellular organisms. They feed on other living things. It could be other animals or living things from the plant kingdom. They use their senses to interact with the environment. So, in summary, there are five kingdoms of the living things: the protist kingdom, the Monera kingdom, the fungi in the fungus kingdom, the plants in the plant kingdom, and the animals. We can also divide them into unicellular or multicellular organisms. For example, in unicellular, we will have the organisms in the protist kingdom and in the Monera kingdom. With the multicellular organisms, we will have the plant kingdom and also the animals. And at last, we have the fungi. In the fungus kingdom, we have living things in both unicellular and multicellular organisms. That was all for this video. I hope you like it and see you in the next one. Bye all!